हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, ए प्रॉब्लम, इनफैक्ट आई से एवरी प्रॉब्लम इज ए चांस फॉर यू टू डू योर बेस्ट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी व्हाट इज कोरोजन। कोरोजन इज ए स्लो प्रोसेस इन विच मेटल्स आर ईटन अप लेयर बाय लेयर बाय द एक्शन ऑफ मॉइस्चर, सम केमिकल और एयर। बाय द एक्शन ऑफ मॉइस्चर, सम केमिकल और एयर, द प्रोसेस slow process in which metals are eaten up layer by layer, that is called corrosion. So that was the definition of corrosion. Now if we talk about corrosion of iron, corrosion of iron, say Fe, then the formula of this is Fe2O3XSO. This X is variable here, and since the content of water in air is not fixed, so we cannot assign it a number. Otherwise, usually we have like this: sodium carbonate decahydrate, copper sulfate pentahydrate, iron sulfate heptahydrate, calcium sulfate dihydrate, and calcium sulfate hemihydrate. Like this, we have the number of water molecules attached with the molecules of the compound are fixed. But here we cannot say so because the content of moisture in atmosphere keeps on varying. So we have put here X. Because of the presence of this water molecule, it is called hydrated iron 3 oxide. Hydrated iron 3 oxide. It is called also called hydrated ferric oxide. It is also called corrosion of iron. It is also called red brown flaky substance, and it is also called rust. Rust. So many metals are getting corroded. Their corrosion is called corrosion of such metal, corrosion of copper, corrosion of silver, like that, and corrosion of iron. But corrosion of iron has been given a special name, that is rust. So if you say rust, that already means corrosion of iron. Corrosion of iron, Fe2O3XS2O. Now by looking at the formula itself, you can see for iron to get corroded, you need oxygen and you need moisture both. Oxygen alone cannot make Fe as Fe2O3XS2O. Also water alone cannot make it. But in normal air, you have both. If you talk about normal air, it contains both S2O plus O2. And if you can talk about normal water, that also contains S2O plus O2. See, very clearly I want to tell you, this O of the water cannot cause corrosion. This is S2O. S2O plus O2, the dissolved oxygen into water, can cause corrosion. So for iron to get corroded, normal water is enough, because normal water contains both S2O plus O2. This is the dissolved oxygen which is found in water. And also normal air contains both. Air contains moisture, and air definitely contains oxygen. So normal air and normal water, iron article gets corroded. To prove it, how to go about? So let us say, if I take a beaker, say like this, and I put an iron nail in this, and I put calcium chloride, CaCl2. This is a water absorbing substance. So after putting this, we will put a stopper. My drawing is very bad, but that does not make any difference. We will put a stopper like this, so that further oxygen and nothing can come in. And here we have put this. So whatever the moisture is there in this S2O, that will be binded by this, and it will contain only air. Initially, normal air was filled. Along with air, we put calcium chloride. Calcium chloride absorbed all the water content that was within this tube, and further the entry was blocked. So now it contained only air without moisture. So keep it for 1,000 years and this nail will not get corroded. So this proves it beyond doubt, that air alone, which definitely might be containing oxygen, but air alone, though it contains oxygen, cannot cause corrosion. Second point, if you want to prove, similarly we can say that take a similar container like this, and you put H2O, and you just boil it before you are putting it like this. So if you heat it, the H2O plus O2, when you heat it, this dissolved oxygen will escape. Further, you put oil on this, so that, and put a stopper also. You have put the stopper. Now even if oxygen wants to come, first of all, it is not allowed to come, and even if it happens to escape some part of it, this oil will ensure that H2O, in H2O, oxygen does not get dissolved. So like this, if you keep a nail into water, which does not have any dissolved oxygen into it, for years and years you can keep, but corrosion will not take place. So this proves it beyond doubt that for the corrosion of iron to take place, the water must be there and oxygen must be there. And once again, let me underline you, this oxygen H2O has got hydrogen and oxygen. This oxygen of water cannot cause corrosion. It is the dissolved oxygen plus this water which can cause corrosion. And that's all about the corrosion of iron. So for the corrosion of iron, the two essential conditions are that the moisture must be present and also it must contain oxygen.